far as eyes are concerned, hollow eyes, sparkling eyes, glittering eyes, large eyes, small eyes, of course. Whereas eyebrows are concerned, thick eyebrows, thin eyebrows. So nose, small and beautiful nose, because it is believed that the small noses are symbols of beauty in fact, and long noses are symbols of wisdom, long nosed ones and open noses, etc. Well, as part of the continuous evaluation activities that were conducted in your classroom, of course a debate or seminar or discussion might have been conducted about the contents of the letter that was written by the father to the headmaster. As we all know, it's a well debated topic. Different groups might have come with different suggestions regarding the contents of the letter. Some might have argued that it was a letter in which, as Swami expected, father was actually detailing the cruelties of Samuel, sir. Some other groups might have said that it must be a letter in which of course father was actually praising Samuel, sir, for being a very strict disciplinarian. At some other maybe of the view that the letter must have actually contained some of course it must have been an informal letter in which father was making some what should I say, inquiries about the progress of Swami's studies. So it can be in any way you like. So so many discussions and so many debates must have been conducted regarding that, and a question in this regard also can be expected. The contents of father's letter is a matter of dispute. Suppose a debate was conducted in this regard in your class. Prepare a paragraph expressing your views in this regard and the reason for that. And when we present our views, these connotations can be of help to you. According to me, as per my conviction, I strongly believe that, I'm of the opinion that, these are the usual connotations we generally use in order to present our views in fact. And there is, of course, nobody has got any suspicion about the main characters of father's help in fact. Swami is there, father is there, Samuel is there, and Swami's mother is there. These are the four main characters of father's help. Each of these characters have got their own distinctive qualities as well, and finding out the distinctive qualities of a character is a very important of course evaluation activity that can be asked in the examination in fact. As far as Swami is concerned, we know he has got so many unique distinct characteristics. He doesn't like to go to school, he is very intelligent, he is very imaginative, that's why he actually cooked up some stories against Samuel. But definitely he has a conscience, he has a conscience, he wants the letter to be justified, that was why he was earning to get punished. He had a conscience that hurt him. So these are some of the character traits that you can find in Swami. As far as Swami's father is concerned, of course he is a very strict disciplinarian, he cannot stand the laziness of Swami, of course it's a very important aspect of his personality, and he is also intelligent. See, why he has constructed the letter is actually a matter of dispute in fact. There is every chance of Swami's father constructing the letter in order to make his son bold to go to school. So he must have constructed the letter to make Swami bold to go to school. In that way also he is intelligent, but there is one problem as far as his character is concerned. He cannot actually understand the feelings, the pains, the whims and fancies of the younger generation. So all these character of course traits can be actually of course contained together, and you can make a character sketch of these characters. There is Swami, there is Swami's father, mother, Samuel, and any of these characters can be asked in order to make a character sketch upon in fact. Now the focus shifts upon drafting dialogues. Here are some guidelines which I would like to present before us in order to of course make the dialogue construction more effective. A dialogue rendering is the give and take part of a language. Suitable responses for the suitable occasions, different kinds of sentences are to be included. responses need not be in full sentences always. Mood of the speaker has to be identified. So these are some basic concepts about drafting dialogues. And as far as the examination point of view is concerned, here is a question that can be asked for the examination in order to present a dialogue. Swami returned home tearing away the letter addressed to the headmaster. At home, he explains everything to his mother. How would be the likely conversation? Of course, mother, what happened, Swami? You seem to be very upset. Swami, nothing, ma, nothing in particular. Mother, did you deliver the letter to the HM? Swami, oh, I couldn't do that. Mother, why? Swami, he is on leave. Mother, don't lie, Swami. I was sure you wouldn't do that. Swami, I swear our HM is on leave. I will deliver the letter as soon as he is back. Mother, I do doubt that. I know you better than others. Actually, in most of the sentences, you can see the mood of the speaker being identified, and of course, the sentences are not actually, of course, full. Not all the sentences are full sentences. And another question regarding drafting dialogues that can be asked is: suppose Swami had met his best friend on the way from school, and if he decides to tell him what happened at school, how would be the likely conversation? This question also can be asked. Now we go on to profiles. We all know profile is an area that has to be attended very carefully. While writing profiles, the following informations may be of help to you. Profile making. Profile is making the given information into a readable sentences. When writing profile, the services of linkers should be sought so that the presentation becomes readable. Ensure that no additional information other than what is given is presented. It won't give you any credit. Now, drafting a profile. Actually, in the last years, what happened was that, of course, in the previous years, what was happening was that we were just giving details about a character. I should say, we are giving details of the author or a very celebrated personality and asking the students to make profiles. But the recent trend is we are giving information regarding a character that they have studied and asking them to make a profile upon that.